Brexit Live, Remainer Hillary Benn withdraws key amendment, but it is bad news for May. Hillary Benn, the chairman of the Brexit Select Committee, has withdrawn his proposal that would have prevented a no-deal Brexit, sparking fears Theresa May is on course for a historic defeat in today's crucial vote. The government whips are believed to have liked the amendment as it could have spared the Prime Minister from a big Commons defeat. On Twitter, Mr. Benn said, "I have decided to withdraw my amendment to the government's withdrawal agreement motion today, which would have rejected both the PMS deal and leaving with no deal. It is vital that we now get the clearest expression of view from the House on the government's deal. Like many others, I will vote against it, but I intend to pursue a no to no deal vote at the earliest opportunity. Since I originally tabled the amendment in December, the House has voted for a no-deal amendment to the finance bill, which is a clear and very welcome indication of MPs' opposition to no-deal. Dominic Grieve's amendment and the Speaker's ruling that a business motion can be amended are also very important, and there is now a proposal for a bill that would allow the Commons in effect to rule out a no-deal Brexit by seeking an extension to Article 50 if necessary. All these developments mean that the House will soon have the opportunity to make it clear that it rejects no deal and so offer reassurance to the many businesses and their workers who are very anxious about the disaster that a no deal Brexit would represent. If the Prime Minister loses tonight, the government must reach out across the House to try and find a way forward. If this don't happen, then Parliament will have to take the lead. MPs have tabled various amendments today as they desperately try and change the course of Brexit. The EU has said they are ready to delay Brexit until July as they believe Theresa May will not be able to get her withdrawal agreement through the Commons. The House of Lords have rejected May's deal by a majority of 169. Votes begin from 7 p.m. today and the main vote is expected at 8:30 p.m. Follow express.co.uk for live Brexit updates below. 10:32 a.m. update. Kate Hoey MP says UK must leave the EU by end of March. Ms. Hoey said in the Daily Telegraph, "I resent the way in which the threat of no Brexit is being used to push through a withdrawal agreement that does not take back control of our money, laws or trade and keeps us trapped under the thumb of the EU with no date to escape in the event of the backstop being used." The Labour MP for Vauxhall said that if May's deal is voted down in the Commons, Mrs. May must still get the UK out of the EU. She said, "The UK must leave the EU at the end of March to implement and honour the expressed will of the British people." 10:12 a.m. update. MP urges peers to grasp the opportunity and freedoms of Brexit. Fareham MP Sila Braverman wrote in the Daily Telegraph that she is unable to support the withdrawal agreement and she will be voting against the Tory government. She said, "Although the government insists that the withdrawal agreement honours the referendum and allows us to take back control, it simply is not what a majority of Leave voters across the country chose." The MP also said this deal betrays the British people and the country should prepare for a clean Brexit on tough terms. She ended saying, "Let us grasp the opportunities and freedoms of Brexit and believe in our great nation." 9:52 a.m. update. Michael Gove MP said there were some MPs determined to prevent Brexit. Speaking on the Today programme, he said, "The real danger is if people do not vote for the government this evening, we face either a no-deal Brexit, with the short-term economic damage that would bring, or worse, no Brexit at all. We know there are people in the House of Commons and outside who have never made their peace with this decision, who want to overturn it." Mr. Gove said the backstop is deeply uncomfortable for the EU because they have made clear that the four freedoms of the single market were indivisible. The Brexiteer quoted Game of Thrones to warns of Brexit vote consequences, saying in the words of Jon Snow, "Winter is coming." 9:25 a.m. Hackney Pizzeria gives 25% off to clients who demand second referendum. Pizzeria Apollo customers need to bring in a copy of a letter or email that have sent their MP expressing their support for a new referendum to benefit from the deal. Owner Oliver Kenny said, "We wanted to do something positive, not something negative. Our tiny little pizzeria in Hackney should do our bit to positively say what we think is the best thing to do." 9:19 a.m. Tory Brexiteer Desmond Swain admits to having second thoughts about voting down the deal. Mr. Swain said, "I am very much aware that the events and votes of the last week pose a present danger to Brexit. I will have to consider carefully over the next 24 hours whether I want to share a division lobby with those who are there because their strategy is to prevent Brexit." 8:17 a.m. Update, Asia markets trade higher as investors wait on Brexit vote. Investors have been keeping a close eye on the British pound as MPs vote on Theresa May's deal to leave the EU. Some analysts have said the vote could trigger a downturn in the market. Analysts at Singapore's DBS Group Research said, "Today's vote is considered a buy the rumor, sell the fact play for the pound, especially if the Brexit agreement is defeated by more than 100 votes. It is still too early to take off the risk for the pound to fall to its post-referendum low near 1.20 this year." 8:05 a.m. Update, the Irish Prime Minister Leo Varadkar due to discuss no-deal Brexit contingency plans. The Taoiseach has said he remains optimistic but must ensure Ireland is prepared for every outcome. The Irish government is due to circulate new information following a document they released in December with its plans.